never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I'll hope in him. Let's read together, whoever has a Bible. Lamentations is not in the New Testament. Lamentations is in the Old Testament. When you are yet to reach the New Testament. Can we read together, church? Yeah. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. You have come. Oh my God. Let's clap for ourselves. Hallelujah. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Say, they are new every morning. Say, they are new every morning. We shall learn together. New every morning. So my word today is something new.
Amen.
Amen. New. Amen. Something what? New. New is coming our way. But let's see what the Lord means to something new. What is this something new? Some definitions say not existing before. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many introduced, discovered recently. Now for the first time. Not previously.
Yeah. Okay.
Owned recently or produced. Unfamiliar or strange way of living. Unaccustomed to doing something. Just beginning new. I think with those words you've gotten something. God is saying he's going to do a new thing. His mercies are new every morning. What does he mean? We've been walking in the old anointing, old thinking. We used to move in the old way of thinking. The way we used to do things last time, then we carry it even today. The way we used to preach or to sing, to intercede, we move with it even today. But when God is saying, my steadfast love never ceases, and my mercies cannot come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Now we move in the yesterday's grace. Here we don't see the victory. We've been persistent in prayer and we believe in the Lord. We know God is there, but we are praying like yesterday. When the Lord has changed the move, we are to kill Goliath in a different way. Last time, David took the stones and killed Goliath. Maybe we are killing Goliath in another way, in another method. But yesterday you prayed and you came to church. You want to do it like yesterday. So today's grace is new. Today's anointing is new. So God wants you to move in a new anointing.
Amen.
New dimension of thinking. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Something new we have to get today. I'm here to announce something new is going to happen in your life.
Amen.
Something which has never been before.
Amen.
You know, in our country, they used to ship all the clothing to our country. And when you buy it, you say, this is a new cloth. It's just a new look, but the cloth is old. But God is serious with his word. When he says something new, he is meaning it. He cannot contradict himself. Something new which has never happened can happen this church in a twinkling of an eye. Praise the Lord. Something new something what's new, beginning new, doing something new. See new things are coming your way.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Don't think like a kidding person. Think like someone who knew every day there's something new God prepares for you. Amen. He prepares a table before our enemies. Amen. A table which is new every day. Praise the Lord. Amen. New anointing is going to happen upon our lives. Amen. We may be stressed. We may feel the stress and the pressure and everything. Then you don't know what comes tomorrow. And very, very well, you don't know what is coming tomorrow. You know what is coming the next hour. But something new from God, it comes up. Praise the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Let us expect something new from our God, the Savior, the Redeemer, the Creator of everything. Praise the Lord. Yes. Why do we expect something bad always? We should expect something new in our lives. Amen. Which has never been before. Amen. Why do we think of something odd? Do you think God cannot give you a new car? Do you think God cannot give you a new dress which no one has ever put it on? God can do it. He cannot contradict himself. But once you believe in yesterday's anointing, you will keep doing the old styles things. You will not bring up something new. You will not birth something new. Because God is saying, my steadfast love and my mercies, my grace is new every morning. Today is new grace and mercy. We are not thinking like last Sunday. Oh, last Sunday, that was very good. And walking that anointing of last Sunday. But today there is another anointing of something new. The way of thinking should change. Amen. Because God means his word. Not existing before. Something, you may die. You may experience death in your life. Death in your business. Death in your marriage. In the relationship. The way you convene with others, the way you do your things, it might bring death in your life. Something might come upon you and you experience death in everything. All hope is gone. But let me tell you one thing. If we cling unto the word of God, if we cling unto the word of God, and he's saying, I'm bringing up something new. Amen. He's meaning it. Let's embrace it. Hallelujah. Let's embrace new relationships. Let's embrace new anointing. Let's embrace new power. Let's embrace new authority. Let's embrace new friends which are taking us on another level. Let's embrace new mothers which are feeding us. Let's embrace new anointing upon our pastor. Let's embrace new power upon our pastor. Let's embrace new jobs. Hallelujah. God is set to do something greater. God is set to do something new. The oil is gone. That is yet to be happening. Praise the living God. Something new is yet to happen. God will give you a child. I don't know whether that person is here. I don't know whether that person is outside of this congregation. But God is here to do something new. I know my God is here to do something new. I know my God left us every mountain before us. We have faced the challenges in life. But God is here to do something new. There are mountains ahead of us. But God is doing something new. He's leveling every mountain. Then we shall walk on a smooth road. Praise the living God. God cannot contradict himself. Jesus is the word. When he says something new, he means it. When he says something new, which has never been before, he means it. Praise the living God. We have ever seen miracles happening. Hallelujah.
Amen.
New relationships. They are this what we call repair. When something is being repaired, doesn't mean it's new. Some people, some businesses, marriages, relationships, ministries, servants of God, God can repair us. We look like new, but I can see it's being repaired. There is that to repair. There is what we call rebuilding. You can repair something like a wall. You can see that wall. It might need repair. To paint white. But before we paint white, something needs to be done. Then afterwards, paint it white. Then you are not doing something new. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not something new. When God means new, it's meaning new. Amen.
Amen.
Our ministry can change into something new. We wake up tomorrow when things have changed.
Amen.
Amen.
You can wake up when things have already changed.
Amen.
In a style that you cannot know. Because you cannot know all the ways of God. You can know your way. Maybe think of the ways of Satan. But you cannot utterly know the ways of God. When we don't know the ways of God, He's God. We cannot know Him and finish Him. No one can deceive you that he knows God from A up to Z. He is the Alpha and the Omega. We shall die and live good to reign. When he says, I'm bringing up something new, he did it to Jonah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He brought us, let's read there. Let's go in the book of Jonah, that the word has just dropped in my mind. Jonah chapter 4, verses 5. Jonah went out of the city and sat the east of the city, and made a booth for himself there. He sat under it in a shade, till he should see what would become of the city. Now the Lord God appointed a plant and made it come up over Jonah. I would love everyone to know that. Over Jonah, that it might be a shade over his head, to save him from his discomfort. So Jonah was exceedingly glad because of the plant. But when the down came up the next day, God appointed a worm that attacked the plant so that it withered. This is it. God made a plant to rise just that particular moment. He made it. God appointed a plan and made it that very time. It became a shade. It grew so fast. Where Jonah was seated, he could not see that plant. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He had made himself as shade, but it was too much sunshine. Then he was too discomforted, too discouraged, because he wanted the people to die. And God had Peter on the city. Then the God, this is what did. Said, this is my servant. Let me help him. He made a plant to grow so fast. That means God has seeds. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means God can plant something there new at that particular moment.
Amen.
At that particular time. People, I want you to think. Let the word be expounded in your life. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That means God came down. That means he dug a pit. Huh? A hole. Is it a hole? Something. And put a seed. Then and commanded it to grow as fast as possible. To rescue his servant from sunshine. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
As fast as possible. save his servant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God made it as fast as possible. Our God is a caring, loving God.
Amen.
He can make something to germinate.
Amen.
On our spot, that very moment.
Amen.
He can make that job come across you that very moment. If you are in a critical moment, if you are in a critical time, God can do it.
Amen.
He made this plant to germinate. Immediately it germinated and made a shed. Can you imagine?
Mm.
It had even branches.
Amen.
Can you imagine if it is a tree? A tree has a tap root. It has a fibrous root. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The tap root went down. Immediately, all the other roots were made in the ground. It germinated and it sprang up. Amen.
Amen.
And all of a sudden brought branches.
Amen.
Our God can bring up something in you like that. He can do it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
To save us from shame,
amen.
From scorn, from reproaches. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you're in a critical moment, God comes down. We are our servants.
Mm.
We are our children.
Mm.
God sent Jesus Christ because he loves us.
Mm.
Then he talked to John. Immediately, see what happened. It might be a shade over his head to save him from his discomfort. Bring something new to save us from discomfort. Clap to the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is germinating power in
Amen.
Our lives. God is germinating authority in our lives.
Amen.
God is germinating wealth in our lives.
Amen.
Riches in our lives. Good friendship. Hallelujah. He's germinating houses to save us from discomfort.
Amen.
He's bringing us new people who are taking us to another level. He's germinating something new in America. He's not germinating something new that you go back to your country. He's germinating something new to save you from discomfort, to save you from discomfort, to save you from scorn, to save you from all these trials, from all these temptations that you've been facing. Oh, we bless the Lord. We glorify our God. The one who's germinating wealth in my life. The one who's germinating wealth in riches. We glorify our life, God. We glorify him. We prophesy. Prophesy upon your life.
Yes,
prophesy
Lord.
Upon your life. Prophesy. Prophesy. God is germinating something new to save you from scorn, to save you from shame, to save you from whatever, to save you from poverty. God is germinating a thing to give us shame.
Yes,
God is bringing a shame in
yes,
this
Lord.
Ministry. God is bringing a shame upon our pastor.
Yes.
God is germinating. God is bringing something in someone in your ministry to help you in this ministry.
Yes.
Oh, to pay the rent and all other things. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
God is bringing singers here.
Yes,
God is bringing keyboardists here. God is bringing intercessors in our
yes.
place. God is bringing all the people that we need to support us.
Yes.
God is bringing the people to support in the ministry. God is germinating us.
Amen.
No one can kill it. No one can kill it. It is only God who can speak to the plant that die and it dies. No one can touch it. The ministry that I'm going to own, that comes to you are going to own, no one can touch it unless God says so.
Amen.
God is bringing a new relationship. God is bringing a husband. No one will touch him. God will protect him until you truly establish in your marriage.
Amen.
God. I know our God is able. I know our God is able.